I'm moving, moving forward every day. Jesus, I just let him lead the way. Every second, every minute, every hour of the day. I'm moving with Jesus every day.
To be seen. Don't you know that you give your life as a sacrifice, just as Christ died for the ones he loved and the one he loves is me.
Everybody ought to know who Jesus is. Everybody should know how much he loves them. How could they possibly know? I guess we'll have to share him. Those who know him must share him. You and I must tell everybody the story of true, true love. We can tell them that Jesus left an exceptionally posh heavenly existence, all the comforts of the galaxies, to come to this little planet to conquer sin so that you and I could be free to love again and enjoy being loved. What did you say? You don't know Jesus? Please seek him with all your heart. In this presentation, we have tried to reveal Jesus Christ to you. We have tried to reveal the God who made you and who loves you. The end of this story is up to you. Will it end with unrequited love? Will you reject Jesus again? Or will you receive him in his fullness? With all the love he's got to give. Will you accept the revelation of Jesus Christ and take him as your Redeemer and Lord? The choice, my friend, is yours.
Time measured out my days. Life carried me along. In my soul I yearned to follow God, but knew I'd never be so strong. I looked hard at this world to learn how heaven can be gained, just to end where I began, where human effort is all in go. The battles I would face, forever running but losing the race, were it not for grace. So is all my praise expressed with all
my heart. It was offered to a friend who took my place and ran a course I could not start. And when he saw in full just how much his love would cost, he still went the final mile between me and heaven so I would not be lost. Were it not for grace, I can tell you where I'd be, wandering down some pointless road to nowhere, with my salvation up to me. I know how that would go.
I know how that would go.
The battles I would face.
The battles I would face. Forever running, but losing the race. Were it not for grace. Forever running, but losing the race.
This story continues with the angel of God saying to the apostles, "Ye men of Galilee, why stand ye gazing up into heaven? The same Jesus which is taken up from you into heaven shall so come in like manner as you have seen him go into heaven." Saints of God, that's amazing, because while those men stood gazing at Jesus ascending into the air, their air was reminded of the promise that Christ would one day return to make them an heir. And yeah, we know not the hour or year, so we need to be steadfast, because if we tarry like the five foolish virgins, we'll be dead last. So let us not be so blinded by the cares of this life that we will forfeit the other one, because if that's the case, the enemy has already won. See, as in the days of Noah were, so shall the coming of the Son of Man be. For as in the days that were before the flood, they were eating and drinking, marrying and giving in marriage, until the day that Noah entered into the ark, and knew not until the flood came and took them all away, so shall the coming of the Son of Man be. Can you imagine that great spectacle? When Christ begins his descent, evil men will be wishing they lived decent. Hallelujah. Imagine a trumpet blowing. Imagine men pointing to the skies, vehicles crashing with commotion. On that day, some will be weeping and others will be praising in devotion. Yes, the good news is that Jesus is coming again. And he told them, "Let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there you may be also." Are you prepared? I want to be there, friends, to enjoy paradise with my dear friends, to have my own mansion and walk the streets of gold. Is my ultimate goal. But until his glorious return, we are to love him unconditionally and be obedient. Put on the full armor of God and never know for what's convenient. But the great news is that we're not in this alone. Oh no, we have a comforter. The Bible says that the righteous are as bold as a lion. So with the Holy Ghost, I am a conqueror. When the Holy Spirit in you, you are reminded that God has not given you a spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. When the Holy Spirit in you, you are reminded that the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, faith, meekness, and temperance. And let us remember Jesus' words. And I will pray the Father, and he will give you another helper, that he may abide with you forever. The Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, because it neither sees him nor knows him. But you know him, for he dwells within you and will be in you.
The sky shall unfold, preparing his entrance. The star shall upload. We shall behold.
Son of God, King of Kings, the Lord.
we have a high priest up in heaven. Hallelujah, oh hallelujah. He's our defender before the Father. In a temple made by God, not man, behind a veil, in a place most holy. Hallelujah, oh hallelujah. Investigated, he clears the records for those redeemed by his own blood.
Friends, I've passed by today to remind someone, to let someone know even today, that we still have a high priest interceding on our behalf in the sanctuary. And he's none other than Jesus the Christ. Let me let you know today, my friend, that he's singularly qualified, uniquely qualified for the office, because he understands what it means to be God, and he knows what it means to be man, and he shed his own blood to set us free. I want you to know today, my friend, that Jesus understands everything that you and I go through, and he has provided a way of escape out of every situation and circumstance. But he's a gentleman God. He would not barge into your life. He would not merely intrude in your circumstance. He stands at the door and he knocks. And he says, come now, let us reason together. Come now, come boldly before the throne of grace, where we can find grace and peace in our times of need. What do you need today, my friend? What do you need from Jesus?
He's blooding out my sins in the sanctuary. He seals my bond with him in the sanctuary up in heaven. He
has done it all for you and I, my friend. He has paid the price. We can come boldly into the sanctuary today because there's still power in the blood of Jesus. He's still writing names in the Lamb's book of life, and he can still keep us sealed. Just meet him in the sanctuary. Do you need healing? Meet him in the sanctuary. Do you need forgiveness, restoration? Meet him today in the sanctuary. Do you need your life turned around? Do you want to experience the transformation that only God can provide? Meet him today, my friend, in the sanctuary. There's still power in the blood. There's still mighty working power in the blood of Jesus. And as your high priest, he's still interceding for you. He's still securing your salvation full and free. Just meet him today in the sanctuary. Don't delay, my friend. He's calling now. Now is the acceptable time. Meet him. Meet our loving Jesus in the sanctuary. God bless you, Rico.